Welcome to NonstopNeuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will talk about delayed compliance or stress relaxation of vessels. We all have experienced that when we stretch a new, tight rubber band, it shows more tension. But if it's kept stretched for a few days, it gets loose. And then, it does not show the same tension. Something similar happens with our blood vessels, too. So let's see that in a vein. This graph shows time on the x-axis, pressure on the y-axis, and the diameter of the vein represents the volume of blood inside. Now let's say everything was fine until now. The vein had a normal volume of blood and the pressure was normal. But now this guy gets a blood transfusion. Initially, a sudden increase in volume causes a marked rise in pressure. However, over minutes or hours, the pressure actually starts to fall and tends to come towards the initial pressure. Thus, initially, the vessels distend like a new, tight rubber band. It tries to recoil, which generates pressure. But over time, the wall gets loose, like how the rubber band gets loose over time. And these loose vessels do not generate as much pressure. So pressure decreases. This happens due to the reshaping of smooth muscle fibers in the vessel wall to adapt to new lengths. This relaxation of vessels during prolonged stress is so conveniently called stress relaxation, or delayed compliance. Now, the reverse is not possible in a lifeless rubber band, but in vessels, we have living muscle fibers. So here, a reverse phenomenon is also seen. When a large quantity of blood is withdrawn, for example in hemorrhage, initially it causes a fall in pressure, but over some time, the fibers reshape in a way that makes the vessel wall tighter. So the pressure starts building up back towards the initial pressure. Can you guess what this reverse type of stress relaxation is called? Reverse stress relaxation. I don't know who named these phenomenon, but I love that guy. This is how things should be named. The name itself is explanatory of the entire concept. Okay, now the importance of this mechanism is that it diminishes the long-term impact of volume change on blood pressure. For example, as we saw, the impact of blood transfusion and hemorrhage is somewhat balanced this way. So this was about stress relaxation of blood vessels. As a quick recap, initially a large change in blood volume causes a rapid change in pressure. But over minutes to hours, the smooth muscle fibers inside the vessel wall shapeshifts in a way that adapts the vessels to the new volume. So the pressure tends to return toward the initial pressure. Now, for sticking with me until the end, I have a special bonus point for you. We saw that smooth muscles in the vessel wall are involved in stress relaxation, right? In fact, this is a property of all smooth muscles. For example, in the urinary bladder too, an increase in volume initially causes more increase in pressure. But over a while, due to stress relaxation of its smooth muscles, there is a fall in pressure, even at the increased volume. That's it for this video. Hey, wait! Does that mean that the smooth muscles are teaching us not to hold on to any stress for too long? Maybe.